All right, everybody, we're back at it again. We know that our millions of fans all across the globe, in every country in the entire world, has been demanding this collaboration for the second time again. The Suscast with Sussy Boy, my good acquaintance slash friend, and me, Zipper Demon. We're going to be talking about, we're going to start off with a particularly hot topic. Not really, but is Star Wars for nerds? I want to hear your take on it first, Nemo.
Before I start off, is good acquaintance a roast for what I did to you last time?
Yeah.
Alright, I see how it is. Alright, but I'd like to start off. I'm going to start off by saying yes, people that like Star Wars are nerds. But I'd like to clarify my statement by saying that I don't think nerds, like, as long as you don't allow it to consume you, I feel like having a good part of your personality, being a nerd, just means, like, you're complex. You can't be, like, cool all the time. And you also can't be, like, a nerd all the time. Like, if the only shows you watch are like Big Bang Theory and you only like Star Wars and stuff like that, then that might be a problem. But as long as you have a good
balance... Like you, right?
No, not like me. I'm a very cool person,
as long as
actually.
You're being like a sussy boy over here.
Yeah, I'm actually really
You're
cool.
always a nerd.
Yeah. I have like... I wear like really cool clothes.
Basically,
and I have, like, frosted tips and stuff. I'm very cool.
Yeah.
You know that.
So basically, long-term short, you're trying to justify being a nerd is a good thing.
Yeah. I think that it's good to have multiple parts to your personality. And Star Wars, if you understand, like, the narrative arc, and you're not just, like, into spaceships, then you're not, like, that type of nerd. You just enjoy a good story. Which some might say, if you're, like, a film nerd, then you'll, like, see different stuff in Star Wars. But I think that's a good thing. Like, George Lucas himself said that, I think he said, as advice for Disney, he was like, one thing I can tell them is it's not a movie about spaceships. Which is very telling, because many science fiction movies are just, like, really bad or really flashy, and they're just, like, endless space battles. But Star Wars is about something fundamentally different. So, yeah, that's my position.
Yeah, I mean, even George Lucas, his own quote, he said that Star Wars, all it is a family drama, but in a different setting. No, but
yeah. To
me, I think that you are right, but I don't think it makes you a nerd. That's like, because it's hard. If you're a diehard Star Wars fan that like has all the books and watched like all the movies again and again, Clone Wars, everything like that, and you know. In and out Star Wars, everything about it, then yeah, you're a nerd.
Yeah.
But if you just like Star Wars, I don't think you're a nerd.
Yeah, I totally haven't.
Because they're good movies.
I totally haven't watched the Clone Wars. No, I would never do that.
No, I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying that's, you know, it's more there to it. So.
Yeah. Alright, I think that's a good place to end that conversation. I think we're largely in agreement about nerds and Star Wars. But let's go off Star Wars. Do you have anything that you want to talk about in particular?
Currently? Like, something that's going on currently or just in general?
Sure, it can be whatever you want. I don't want to put you on the spot, but I want to see how fast you can come up with something.
Well, I mean, we've talked about a lot about movies last time. So I heard you don't want.
You're kind of breaking up. Maybe put the mic closer to your mouth.
All right, is this better?
Yeah, you're a little bit. I think your
Is
internet.
this better?
Yeah, it should be, but I'm just worried your internet is cutting off a little bit, but you should be good.
Okay. Let me know if the quality gets better.
It's good so far.
Okay. Well, what are you thinking?
All right. If you like anime, are you a weeaboo? This is close to your heart, I know.
Yeah. As you might think, I'm not an avid anime watcher, to be honest. I mean, I liked the only anime I've ever seen is Inuyasha, and I haven't even seen all of it. I don't even watch that. It's fun. It's a cool show, but it's more of an older anime and not as popular, obviously. And yeah, I mean, that's about it.
I'll tell you, I've had a bit of a conversion on this subject. I was quite anti-anime, mostly as a joke, I'd say. I didn't hate people that like anime, but I was just like ready to roast them at any moment. But I feel like you've softened my opinions about anime. Because I had no idea you were into anime, but when I found out, not that you're into anime, but you're into that show. And it
I've
surprised
seen
me.
it, yeah.
Yeah, it surprised me. So I softened my opinion a bit. So I haven't really seen anime, but I'm open to it now.
Yeah, I don't know if it's quite your thing, though.
It might not be.
Yeah.
But if it was quite your thing, you would finish it, right? You cut out. What did you say?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's what do you think we should move on to? Different aspect on your life and our life and our lives, my life, your life.
Let me think. All right. I just like to bring up a quarrel I had with my mom a few weeks ago. So I got her really mad, okay, over something not that important, but it was important to me because I feel like the principle is relevant. So I told her very specifically, I want a number one from In-N-Out. A number one. It is a double with cheese. She goes to In-N-Out. She comes back with two singles. And she says, I got you two number twos. And I'm like, what was the point of me telling you if you're just gonna ignore what I said and just get me two doubles? And she freaked out and she was like, oh my God, you're so ungrateful. I said, I'm not ungrateful. I'm concerned with getting the food I want and not having it screwed up. It takes little of her and would mean the world to me to have the right food. And I told her, next time you want chicken, I'm getting you fish. Imagine that. And like not like good fish, like gefilte fish or something like that. I'm gonna get you the smelliest, most disgusting fish on the menu. To me, that is the number two compared to the number one. I just like the number ones now. It's important to me that I get it in. Okay.
Well, that was a nice rant.
Yeah, I was quite annoyed with that, and she went crazy. Hey, how about you tell us about,
Yeah.
let me think here. How about you tell us about how you love SpongeBob and you still watch it even though you're a senior in high school?
I don't like SpongeBob at all.
Okay, guys,
Actually, I have a
he's lying.
I
He
have
doesn't. This is all bull. This is bull, what he's about to say.
No.
He acts like he hates it, but he's privately admitted multiple times that he
I've said that
exaggerates it.
it's fine. I do exaggerate.
Oh, it's fine. See? See?
Yeah,
He was
but I
about to
do
say he
just
hated it.
I have a grown I have not an like a born inherent hatred towards it, but just it's over time. I've just it's gotten worse and worse, at least. Because my brother consumes the houses and the TVs with SpongeBob.
Okay, can I point something out? I
Sure.
told this to you months ago, and you denied me. You were like, no, it's not because of my brother. But I told you months ago, I think we were probably playing Doom. I was like, Ethan, I bet the reason you quote unquote hate SpongeBob is because your brother watches it. Do you remember this?
I mean,
Huh? What is he gonna
I think
say?
so. I think so.
Oh, he thinks so. I think this is selective memory, because I clearly remember telling you, and you denied it. You remember. He's lying, you guys. He remembers really clearly.
Okay, and so what if that's the reason?
Just not so what? It's like I was right. You don't hate SpongeBob. You
I
only.
do.
Oh, now he hates SpongeBob. He doesn't know what to believe. But he
What
agreed
do you
that I
mean?
was right. Oh, I like that podium. Kind of. I mean, kind of. It looks okay. Nah, I don't like it. Never mind.
Yeah, you don't know what to believe either.
Yeah, I don't. For that, I don't. At least I can admit it. Right?
Well, I do on this one, so.
I'm glad. All right. Ethan, you say something that you want to say.
With SpongeBob or something else?
No, I already know all your thoughts related to SpongeBob. I knew them months ago.
Yeah, I don't know about that one. I don't think
Notice
that's
how,
really
like,
true.
almost everything I say about you becomes true after a while.
I don't think so.
Case in point, this is totally exactly what I told you. You denied all of it vehemently. And you even said, I have a good read on you, so you can't deny it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have the text conversations to prove it. Anyway, I'm gonna take the topic somewhere else here. Do you think the person that is president should want the job? Like, or do you think they should be slightly reluctant to prevent against like a person that abuses the office because he wants it so much and will like do anything to save himself and his power?
I think, well, I mean, there's obviously both, right? I mean, you can't say that one is bad, one is good.
True.
Just the trait does not determine whether the president is good or not.
The trait.
Yeah, whether he or she is reluctant or just wants it.
Possibly. You make a good point. Okay, but the cynical side of me says if the person doesn't want it, it's a higher likelihood that the government will be unstable because he or she won't be willing to like crush people that are trying to like usurp the throne, you know?
Yeah.
So I got this from my English teacher last year. She said that I think it's dangerous when someone wants to be president. Which I was like, yeah, it's a very nice thing to say, but if the person doesn't want it, someone who wants it will probably just take it from them. And it might not be too pretty. Like, it won't be like violent always, but it might involve a weak president, which might not be a good thing.
Yeah, I can see that. But I don't think just that one thing determines it, right?
Oh yeah, definitely not. Because yeah, a lot of people want these things.
Lot of people.
Yeah. All right, next thing I'm gonna ask is when's the last time you lied? And when do you think it's acceptable to lie?
The last time I have,
Yeah.
well, let me start with when it's acceptable. I think it is acceptable when you're dependent on it in some form or another.
Wait, can you repeat that? Your mic was cutting off.
Yeah, I think that it's acceptable when you're dependent on it in some form or another.
So it's like to advance your
So,
interests.
yeah, well, yeah.
Very Machiavellian, very Machiavellian. Yeah, I get that. I get that. And I agree.
But I also believe that sometimes just being honest, even though it doesn't seem like it initially, will eventually get you better off.
Yeah, sometimes, but sometimes there are things people can't know. And if you tell them, it will be the end of something. So I think the truth has the power to kill as much as it has the power to heal. So I feel like lying could save people a lot of heartache, including yourself.
Yeah. What's that quote where it's like the hard truth is worse than a easy lie or something?
Oh wow, you remember that? Oh my God. Wow. Man, can't believe you remember that. It's one of my favorite quotes. It's a little more like fancy than you put it, but it's a deception that elevates us is greater than a host of low truths.
Yeah.
It's a very fancy way of putting it, but it's like a lie that takes us somewhere and gets us someplace is better than us being honest and going nowhere. Like, if we believe this lie and we have a future, then it's okay. Like, imagine like a marriage. Maybe the marriage is based on a lie that you maybe you love each other, but you're at least happy and you like do stuff together and you're friends. But maybe your relationship's based on truths and you hate each other and like you can't stand each other and you're going nowhere. But I'd say that that quote applies a lot in like foreign policy, where I think we lie to ourselves about who our friends are. But it does take us places, and it's necessary in many cases. Politics is a lot of lies. Like people think like politics is like fact checking, like fact check the lies, but the lies are like much bigger than that, and they're like unfact checkable. They're built in. They're systemic lies.
Yeah. Some people don't like that, though.
Many people don't like it, but the fact that they don't like it probably means they don't understand it. And you are very afraid of what you don't understand. People are very afraid of what they don't understand. But
That's true.
yeah. It's very hard to make the case for a lot of the things we do that are not we, like everyone does in politics, that are very unappealing on paper, but they like do good things for the most amount of people.
Yeah. I couldn't say that better.
Thank you, Ethan. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. I'm just happy you remembered my quote. I'm actually shocked that you remember that.
Your
Shocked.
quote.
Not my quote, but I told you it. Yeah,
Yeah.
it's one of my favorite quotes.
Yep. That's a good one.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
I'll remember that. You remembered it. I will remember that.
Yeah.
All
Okay. So, what should we what's what should we do next?
I saw recently today that you tweeted something to me, that Robert Pattinson, the Batman actor, tested positive for COVID-19. What are your thoughts about that?
Yeah, that's, I mean, it's already been, the production for that movie has already been delayed, before. Now it's again, and of course the main actor. So, and I'm, excited for that movie. It's, Batman back in 2021. Probably not 21 anymore, but still.
I have pretty vivid memories. For some reason, I remember it. There's no reason I should. I remember sort of cringing slash like I was surprised about how obsessed you were with the Joker. Like I remember you showed me the trailer in 10th grade, I believe it was, early 10th grade, like one of the first days of school. And I obviously liked the movie, but I was like so surprised you're so taken by it. I was like, it's probably just gonna be a crap movie, and they're probably just gonna ruin the character. But then when I saw the movie, I was very like taken with what they had done, and like I thought they took it to new levels that Heath Ledger didn't go to, and it was a really good addition to the character and like a new unique take. So, even though I'm a little nervous that the new Batman movie might be kind of terrible, I will give it a chance because, I feel you're excited for it. And I didn't give the Joker film a chance when you were talking about it. I was just like, this is going to be terrible. So I'll give it a chance and I will be excited for it. I just hope they don't go beyond the Call of Duty to ruin Batman, which I think DC has done. I know you haven't seen Batman versus Superman or even Justice League, but I think the direction they took the characters, like, really, like, simplistic. They just reversed the no kill thing and they made him like a violent brute. And that's supposed to make him complex because, like, now he's not anti-violent. He just, like, beats the crap out of people and kills them. And I just thought it was boring. It's like, fine, make him have some conflict with killing people, but don't make it he's just like a killing machine all of a sudden. It's like not Kill Bill. She's not going in there like cutting heads off. So wrong audience, in my opinion.
Might be a good thing that I haven't seen them.
Yeah, I did not enjoy them. I was very frustrated when I saw it. I saw it with my parents. My dad doesn't like Batman at all, so he didn't care. But he even said that Ben Affleck was lame as Batman, even though he doesn't like Batman. But yeah, I was very disappointed.
Well, I think the new suit looks cool, and I actually over t I watched again the trailer, and I actually really like that Batmobile. You know?
Yeah, it's all right. I mean, I prefer the look of the Dark Knight, but I know they shouldn't just
Cooler.
remake. I know they shouldn't remake the Dark Knight. I wouldn't be happy if they did that. But we have to see.
Yeah.
I'm willing to give it a chance as a fan of Batman.
Yeah, well, the last, like, I mean, considering 2020 and 2019, I know there's, like, been Joker and things like that, but movies have really just been, kind of down. Just not good anymore. I mean, they're going is, like, probably down a lot. Not during COVID time, but I mean just like in general. Like there's no like blockbuster hits that everyone's so excited for as much as before,
2019, in my opinion, or just like our modern times in general. But mostly 2019 was like filled with a lot of disappointments. Mainly Rise of Skywalker was a very sad movie. But I was very happy when I saw Joker. I thought it was so different to what we usually see. Like, it was not a safe movie at all. It got people really angry to the point where they said it would start mass shootings everywhere, which is usually a sign that the movie's good.
Controversial is good.
Yeah, I think in today's age probably is. See, like every time Tarantino makes a film, they always like bash him for something. Like he made a film about slavery and there was controversy over like the N-word and stuff like that. But he makes pretty great films and they're actually worth watching. Like Django Unchained, that movie, I don't think you've seen it,
Yes.
but I enjoyed it a lot. And I was actually quite young when I saw it, and I enjoyed it a lot.
Yeah, and I think you know a movie that's also very controversial that you like a lot and I like a lot. It's been banned after a mere
Oh,
murder.
you're cutting out. Oh, mirror murder. Okay, you said after a mirror murder.
Yeah, Copycat Murder after it was released, A Clockwork Orange by Stanley Kubrick.
All right.
Yeah. So you like that movie, right?
Yes, very much so.
A lot. There's many that movie controversial. And I think can't be not controversial, even if.
You're cutting out a lot.
Oh.
You're totally blank right now.
Can you hear me
Yeah, I can.
now? Okay. Hopefully the internet gets better over here, down in the wastelands.
Yeah. So you said you don't think a movie, that good movie can't be controversial? I don't know what you were saying. You're blacking out.
Oh, I said that A Clockwork Orange, even if you like the movie and agree with it, it's still controversial in your own. Can you hear me?
No, you blacked out again at the end.
Okay.
We can move on.
Okay.
But yeah, I think that the movie wouldn't work if it wasn't controversial. Like, it's thought-provoking because it's like something you've never really seen before.
Yeah.
I remember when I saw Silence of the Lambs, I was like shocked by how like ballsy it was, like especially at the beginning. Like I thought it was so like in your face and so provocative. But
Yeah.
if it wasn't, I probably would just forget what it was about.
What about that you said you have HBO Max with and Gone with the Wind is on that, correct?
Yes.
So you said they added this segment before you would watch it.
Yeah, so basically, there's controversy over films that involve black stereotypes, and they originally removed the film, but they re-added it with like a message before it, like telling people about slavery. So,
Yes.
I think that we should still watch the movies. I don't think you shouldn't not watch controversial films, but I guess if you need to know stuff about slavery, you can always watch the thing they put in front of it. Or if you already know and it doesn't affect how you think about black people, then you should watch it. Yeah. So what do you want to talk about now? Let's move away from movies.
Yeah. What do you think? How about let's just talk about just how about COVID? Just what's going on?
Oh, okay. That's a good idea. So we're in the online school, senior year online school, and
You think it's good?
I personally don't feel like I'm learning nearly as much. How about you?
Same thing. Yep, I agree
Yeah.
with you.
I have a hard time focusing like way more than usual. Like the only class last year I really didn't focus in was like chemistry towards the end because I was like going to my death, my funeral, and I was just trying to have fun. Basically, we sat next to each other. It was a fun class. Nice teacher, but it is not my forte, you know. You were good at it. But now every class just feels like just a drag. And I feel like I'm in a prison too. Because, like. Wait, what did you say?
It's called senioritis.
Yeah, except, well, I guess this is on steroids, because I still want to get good grades, but I can't focus in these classes because, first of all, the teachers. There's only a few, like one or two, that teaches a lot in the class. Most of them just like talk about random stuff and complain about the software and how stuff is going wrong and tech stuff. My Spanish teacher spent, I think, like maybe 40 minutes on numbers, like tens, twenties, thirties, forties, like 40 minutes. And I just tuned it out because A, I already know, B, it's just too long. I can't focus 40 minutes on numbers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, for biology, the same teacher that we had for chemistry last year, actually. So we're assigned notes from a textbook, obviously, and it's a college level class, so obviously there's a lot of it. But he says that, we're responsible for teaching ourselves. We read the notes, I mean, read the textbook, take notes, and then when we're in class, all we do is just get updates on what homework is, and maybe do, a lab activity one time a week of a week, or once every 2 weeks. That's all it is. What is that?
I have a friend who goes to school in Newport Coast, and their teachers can only keep them for 45 minutes max. I think it's way more realistic because I feel like the teachers like really only teach for like maybe 30 to 45 minutes apart from physics. But I honestly think that they spend a lot of time like dragging stuff out just to keep us there.
Yep.
Yeah, but we're just waiting. I read recently that I believe it's pronounced Pitzker or Pfizer, actually, sorry. Pfizer, the medical company, has stated they're going to have a vaccine by October, and the CDC has notified states that they should begin vaccine distribution by November the 1st. So hopefully we'll have an end to our summer of discontent, summer and spring of discontent. Usually winter symbolizes like a war or like bad times, but I guess in our thing it was during the spring. And then we'll have some good adventures. You and I will go, we'll go on our trip that we were planning on going that was canceled, and we'll have a lot of good fun there. We just gotta get that vaccine.
Yep.
And the people that don't want to take it are perfectly like obliged to not take it, but they're just gonna have to stay home. And I think that's going to be a great motivator for people to get the vaccine because it's not like the flu. Like, if you get the flu, like, eh, people don't even care. But, like, you have
Yeah, because it's so
COVID-19.
normalized.
Yeah, you get COVID-19 because it's a new thing. They, like, lock you up. But I recently went on a trip, like, a little trip to Arizona. And the masks wearing on the plane was very difficult for me because I have like mild asthma and my lung capacity isn't that good. So in like those really hard to breathe masks, I felt like I was like almost falling asleep because I was so like strained from not having enough oxygen. And my mom kept asking me if I was okay, but thank God it was only an hour flight, so I'm ready to travel with no mask, hopefully.
Yeah. Sounds like fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So. Oh, my recording has stopped.
Right now.
Yes.
Click it again. Is it on again?
Recording isn't working.
Okay, well, I'm recording your audio anyway.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, at least you'll get some gameplay. Some of my awesome gameplay.
Yeah, so his audio just cut out, so it should be fine.
Can
Miga?
you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. Is it recording my audio?
Yeah, you're good.
All right. So now what do you want to move on to?
What's something you hate? Not that I'm demanding, because you said that last time. Something you just hate in general. Doesn't have to be about me.
SpongeBob.
Don't
Just
lie.
kidding. That's not a lie.
It is a lie. You've explained multiple times that you over-exaggerate.
No.
Oh, come on.
Okay, let me see what I hate. I hate, well, actually, you've told me this also that you hate it, but I hate people that tell me obvious things that I don't need to hear.
Yes.
They think they're helping me, but they're just making it worse.
Yes, thank you. Like my mom yesterday, she kept asking me, like, not that this is an obvious thing, but sometimes she's like, make sure you get 100% on that test. It was like, okay. Thanks. You're a help.
You helped me out right there.
Yeah, and then
That doesn't really help.
the bad thing about it is these people that tell you obvious things, they do it so that when you do it, they like can feel like they've helped you. Like if I get
Yeah, they like
100%,
think they're like telling you something you haven't heard.
yeah, it's like if I get 100%, they're like, wow, and then they feel good about themselves because they reminded me to get 100. It's like, what? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, obvious things are bad. And then there's those people in class. I'm not going to say who, but it was a person in my math class last year would like ask the most insane questions. Like she would, it's a calc class, but she would ask like questions about addition, basically. And it was really embarrassing, but she's like a
Did the
teacher.
class laugh?
No, but I was sitting next to one of my friends, and we would always point it out that like she was just asking things that everybody knows, including her. She was just doing it to
Oh, just
like,
to ask, yeah.
yeah, like a
I know that, yeah.
teacher's pet.
Yeah.
You just want to like show that you're engaged by asking random, just dumb questions. Oh.
Yeah. Well, that's something I hate also.
You know what I hate? I hate when people touch my Adam's apple. I really get annoyed when people touch my Adam's apple. And I have a cousin. Two of my cousins have like really visible Adam's apples. And I have this other cousin that's very immature, but he like goes up and touches it. And I'm like, stop, I can't look at that. It's so weird. Why are you doing that? Yeah, I have like PTSD or something.
Yeah.
I know you don't mind, I don't think, when people touch your Adam's apple. Do you?
No.
Yeah, you don't really mind. You've got a very thick neck, so it's kind of, I bet it's hard to find.
Yeah.
Want to tell everybody how you don't get tased on your sides?
Well, I do. It's just not as effective, I guess.
Yeah, you got like layers of protection, am I right?
Yep.
Yeah. I was trying to get in there, like trying to tase you, but I kind of got a little bit of success. You're kind of cracking up a little bit.
Yeah, you do that to Raj all day. Another friend.
Yeah. I'm very ticklish there as well, as people know, unfortunately. Okay, let's do would you rather. Would you rather go skydiving or have someone pull off your toenail?
Skydiving.
Same. Oh, that's surprising. Not, I thought you were gonna answer that, but I thought you'd take a long time. But I have a thing about like parts of the body like coming off. Yeah,
You know a lot about that.
No, I funded his sex change, everyone. He's just projecting.
Yeah, you stole that joke from me.
I
Well,
don't
actually,
know
from a
what you're
movie.
talking about.
From a movie.
I don't watch movies.
Yeah, you do. You stole that one from a movie.
Goodwill Hunting.
Yep.
It's a pretty good movie. It's more for people that are quite emotional, I'd say.
Yeah.
And like Matt Damon a lot. Or that woman with the really strong jawline.
Yes.
She looks like she could fit a whole cabbage in her mouth.
Okay.
Hey, I'm just saying, her jaw is like big. And she's got like a
Yeah.
British accent. You know, Americans are in love with people with British accents, they think they're like so smart. That's the only reason people thought Stephen Hawking was smart. Fun fact. Like,
Really?
yeah. Oh wait, crap, he doesn't have a British accent. He doesn't have a voice. Whoops.
Wow.
Oh, I'm falling out of the map. What's going on? Whoa.
That should be funny. Good glitch. Wait, what do you mean you fell out of the map? I see you.
Wait, what's actually funny? What are you saying?
That would be a funny glitch if you fell out of the map.
Yeah, I did, dude.
Yeah, we'll see it on video recording.
You asked me, would you rather?
Right. Let's see. Would you rather be able to teleport or have telekinesis?
Well, it's telekinesis is moving objects.
Yeah, mind powers. So teleportation or telekinesis?
My instincts tell me telekinesis.
But teleportation, though.
I mean, like, where do I go that's so far? Like, I mean, if I want to go on a trip, I
You
just.
don't need to go far, also.
I don't know. I feel like telekinesis could save my life. Well, I guess maybe teleportation can. Oh, that's a
The
hard one.
force.
It's a hard one. I'll say telekinesis because teleportation. I feel like it would get old. Like, I just go everywhere. Yeah, telekinesis.
All right.
How about you?
I'd probably go with telekinesis.
All right. Okay, let me ask you one. Would you rather play this game for the rest of your life? Or, I don't want to make it too difficult. Or would you like have that thing happen to you in Alien? Where like that thing comes out of your like chest you know? And like
That
you give a baby basically of an alien.
this game.
Seriously, you played this game for the rest of your life? You survived the alien.
I don't know.
Dude, trust me, you can't play this game for the rest of your life. You learn to hate it. Let's say 6 hours a day.
What do you mean? I
Yeah.
don't play video games 6 hours a day.
Well, no, that's part of the equation. You have to play this game 6 hours a day.
Oh, then.
Even so, I mean,
Yeah, the alien thing, I guess.
even if it's 1 hour, like, imagine playing this in 20 years. It's gonna, like, you can't play the new Doom game. Imagine how that's gonna feel. You're just stuck
Much.
playing Eternal.
Eternally.
Yeah. Oh. Whoa. I didn't even know that. Dang. That's a good joke.
Doom is eternal.
Yeah. That's the ultimate, like, incel
Yeah.
meme, you know? Women are temporary, but Doom is eternal. It's just meant for
Yeah.
incels.
Like you.
Right.
Yep.
Oh, that's ironic coming from you.
Nope.
Yeah, tie. I won't say it here, but he says we tie in something. That's very complimentary to me. But anyway, do you know what criticism of Joker was that it fuels incel culture?
That's dumb.
Like, that's what they took from the film. Like, people that don't like it, like, that hate it, they took that Joker is, like, celibate, and that's the reason, like, he's an incel. So he, like, takes out his anger. Usually, incel, like, violence is supposed to be against women, but how does he even take out his violence against women?
Yeah. Nope.
Yeah. And you have to be a pretty big, like, ass to, like, take that from the Joker. You're supposed to, like, empathize with the fact that he's, like, depressed. But if you take away that he's an incel and he's, like, a loser, and he should, like, you shouldn't make this film, that's kind of says a lot about your personality.
Yeah.
Yeah. I recently saw a director's roundtable with like Martin Scorsese and
De
Todd
Niro.
Phillips. No, Todd Phillips, the guy who made Joker, and a few other directors, like the guy who made Marriage Story and stuff. And Todd Phillips was talking about how he essentially left comedy. Because he's a comedy writer, he wrote on Borat, he wrote on, he did Hangover and the Hangover movies, and like films like Road Trip. And some people think that the Murray Franklin show is like woke culture and like woke comedy, and they like get to decide all like the rules of what's funny, and they don't allow dark humor on their show, but yet they're kind of hypocritical, and they have like no compassion for like someone like Arthur, who's
Yeah.
like really messed up, but like Murray just makes fun of him the whole time.
Yeah.
I remember when I watched that movie, I really liked the scene when he's in his mom's like hospital room. And he's like watching Murray Franklin, but then Murray starts like mentioning him, and he's just staring at the screen, like with a
Yeah.
blank expression. I was like, whoa, like that's gotta hurt. Because Murray's supposed to be like his father figure. Yeah, I really liked the movie. I watched it, I believe, 3 times.
That's I watched it twice, two times.
Yeah, both in theaters for you. I watched it once in theaters, and I watched it with one of my cousins from Minnesota, and then I watched it again with my cousin that lives here.
Nice.
Yeah. So when do you think you want to wrap up the podcast? Do you want to go for like half an hour more or what?
What do you feel like?
I could go for longer, but I don't know if you have anything to do.
No, I'm good for now.
All right.
Can hang around a couple more matches. Just got a notification. You know, the Angry Joe show, right?
Yeah.
3.27 million subscribers. You just posted a review for Mulan, the new live action Disney
Oh,
remake, and he said that it's very bad.
let's talk about Mulan. Have you ever seen Mulan?
I can't recall if I have.
Okay. I actually like Mulan. I don't watch like Disney stuff and like animated stuff. It's
Yeah.
actually a good movie.
Maybe I should watch it because maybe that's what I said. Should have said that I hate animated movies like Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Like 98% Rotten Tomatoes and like a really high audience score as well.
Well, don't you just not like the
People
story
love that
for that?
movie. Yeah, that movie, I don't like the movie itself, but I just have an inherent just like
Yeah.
distaste to
Of
animated
course. Of
movies.
course you want like live action, but trust me, Mulan's a good movie and she's actually a good character. Like, it's an interesting concept. And I don't really like the fact they made a live action. Like, I'm not a Mulan purist, but I'm just like, make a new character. I don't want to see Mulan live action. Make another female Disney princess. That's also cool.
Have you seen the Lion King live action?
I've never even seen The Lion King.
Really?
Yep.
I don't remember it, but I know I've seen it.
Yeah, I've never seen it, actually.
Yeah, have you seen Wizard of Oz?
Nope.
Really?
I
Wow.
haven't. I've only seen like a few of like those really kiddie movies.
Yeah. Think Wally is the best.
Yeah, I watched Wall-E. I liked Wall-E. I like Up. I saw that a while ago.
Yeah, Up is okay.
Think it's a good movie. The story isn't too good, but the characters are really good.
Yeah.
What other animated movies have I seen?
Incredibles.
Yeah. I always kind of cringe at that movie, though.
Which one, the second or the
I've
first?
only seen the first. Like, I liked it,
Oh.
but I don't like how people are, like, obsessed with it.
Yeah. And then obviously there's Toy Story.
Yeah, I've seen the first one, I'm pretty sure, but I was very young. All right, tell me why Minecraft is so bad.
I don't think it's so bad. I just don't think that it could hold me for more than 5 minutes.
It's because you've never like built a world and you didn't get invested. Like I like basically I have like bursts of like enjoyment on Minecraft.
Yeah.
So I like play for like maybe a couple weeks straight and then I stop playing for months. And I just have like a really good world and I like have stuff I like to build on it. But it does get very boring sometimes. But you actually have to be engaged in playing with other people is fun. But I have like a storyline to my worlds, so it's kind of like role playing. I guess my position in this world.
I don't know.
I'm the emperor.
That's not a surprise.
Yeah. It's fun, dude. We have like a whole history. We have laws. We have like a constitution. One time, my cousin, who's like the chancellor, tried to basically overthrow me, and I had to kill him. And I rewrote the whole constitution and basically gave me unlimited power. But you know,
That's pretty good.
I do the best job. He's a schmuck. He doesn't know what he's doing. I built him like this awesome house for him to live in. I made a great house too. It's like a massive palace. I'll actually show you soon. I need you to see my creation.
All right.
My ears hurt.
So, are you wearing a headset?
Yeah, it really hurts.
Do you wear headsets often?
No, I don't.
Yeah, it might be that.
Do you? You wear them all the time.
Yeah.
So, I hear you like earlobes.
Actually, if you look in the Urban Dictionary, your name says that find earlobes mouth-watering,
You
which
look
is
at me.
interesting because that's true for you.
Well, I don't know about that. I feel like you're just saying that. But let's
Yeah.
talk about your Urban Dictionary thing.
Yeah. What about it?
What was yours? What did it say? Do you remember? Because I don't. But I remember it's kind of true, right?
Yeah, it's just all good things. It's very true.
Mine's pretty good as well.
Yeah.
A lot of them are like, it has like she in it because my name is like a girl's name in Swahili.
You are a girl.
All right, I am a girl. You wish, Ethan, you wish. But
No,
we don't have
I
to
paid
talk
for
about it.
your sex reassignment surgery.
You performed it when I was asleep. It was involuntary. But you did a terrible job and it just it's you didn't do it right.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, this guy's a weird guy. He was like basically violated me. But it's okay. Nothing really happened because he doesn't know what he's doing. He just like put everything inside itself and it all popped out.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. In your dreams, buddy.
You're the one that said it, buddy.
I said I paid for it.
You paid for it with your labor. We don't know
Yeah.
you don't have that kind of money to spend. You said that you can't buy video games till Christmas. You can't buy
Yeah.
a $3.99 video game. You don't have the money to spend on a sex reassignment. It's not covered. It's the insurance companies don't cover it. Well, enough talking about what Ethan wants me to do with my future. Let's talk about the past. It's a good
All right.
segue, right? But
Sure.
I don't know what I'm talking about.
I guess you really don't.
I really don't.
That's a good one.
Do you remember when your brother took a crap in your toilet and didn't flush it? And then
Yep.
I went in the bathroom and I was like, Mamma mia, it's a big poop.
Yeah,
And then
yours.
it was not mine, okay? I don't not flush. I'm civilized. I'm not like an ape. I don't just like crap and move.
Yeah, that's good.
You also remember when you used to bang your hands on a lunch table and go, hoo, 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 hoo. You remember
Yeah.
that? Everyone thought you were like, I want to be delicate here. Everyone thought you were like you'd lost your marbles and like this was the last time we were going to see you before the asylum trip. Oh yeah. We don't have to worry about anyone hearing this because no one's gonna watch it. So I guess we're using everyone's names now. Good one, Ethan. Yeah, maybe.
Maybe.
Just kidding. You're right. You did it tastefully. I thought it was funny.
Okay.
You know that thing you do in the pool when you're like, do it right now, actually.
Which one?
That sound you make when you go under the water and you like make this like crazy sound. It's like, boom, boom.
Yeah, I can't do it now.
Try.
No.
Can you just do what I ask? I don't
Nope.
want to have to beg you. Just do it. You're not giving what the people want to see.
They're not seeing anything.
The millions of viewers of this podcast are outraged. Just give them it. Come on.
I think you're the only one outraged.
I am outraged.
Good.
Okay, you say something, boy.
Boy.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's acting like that's weird. You should hear the things this guy does.
Right.
Say something, Ethan. Like,
Something.
no, like, move on to another subject.
All right. Well, I don't think we could talk about this really quickly and then move on, but Doom DLC has been fully revealed. It sounds like it's going to be not just the traditional DLC. They said it's the second part of a two chapter, book. It's going to be as long, equivalent to the length of the main story. And I think that's awesome.
Do you think that's because the main story excluded women and people of color from the story, so they had to make a reboot?
Well, I mean, it has all the demons there is. I mean, there are female demons. But some may say that's sexist because you're killing them.
Don't know. I'd have to talk to a woman about that. Like you.
Talk to yourself.
No, like you. I said it first, so I'm right.
Nah.
You know what's funny, you guys? He said I had to get a reassignment to become a woman. But for him, I'm not saying that. He's just a woman.
No. I said I
No,
no.
no, no.
Everyone
No,
knows
no,
that
no.
you're
No,
no.
no, no.
Everyone can
No,
hear
no,
your
no.
voice. It's
No, no, no.
obvious you're
I have a massive,
a freaking.
deeper voice. What are you talking about? My
Yeah,
voice is so
exactly.
much
That's
deeper
the
than you.
point. You've changed your voice.
Men naturally have more testosterone than women do. You realize
Yes.
this?
Yes. That's why
Yes.
you've changed your voice. Now it's deeper. It used to be so girly. Because that was what you
What,
were.
like what you're talking about. You're right now it's girly. And the girl is not like Scarlett Johansson. It's like Kathy Bates. You're like Kathy Bates girly. You don't even know who that is.
Not at the moment.
Ah, yeah, you should search her up. She's a real beaut.
No.
What
Oh my
amount of damage I did? I did so much more. Oh, you searched her up.
Yeah.
Yeah, Kathy Bates.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think we're getting to a close here. You want to recap, or what are you gonna do? Final topic?
Let's do one more, Ethan. Oh, and
All
on
right.
Tundra again.
On what?
Tundra.
Tundra? All right.
Whoa, look
So.
at that guy. Whoa. That sounds kind of interesting.
Yeah, he's better than you. He's that guy named Zipper Demon right there. That's who you were talking about, right? Hello. I think I can't hear your audio right now. Can you hear my audio? Yep, something's not working because I can't hear you at all. It's either my or your internet. Well, I'll wait until it comes back. Hello. I think it's your
Hello?
mic. Oh, I can barely hear you. It's very quiet.
Hello?
It's getting louder.
Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, we're back.
Yeah, we're back in business.
Alright, sorry for that interruption, but we are back now.
Sussy Boy's tech is lacking here because
I have a $2
he
mic.
doesn't have the up-to-date mics.
Yeah.
I mean, I
Oh.
got mine for free, and it's way better than his.
Yeah, he stole it from a poor kid.
No.
Stole it from my brother, Jude. Ethan, I'm trying to make a match. It won't let me. You're in like tutorial or campaign or something?
No, I'm in right now. I think my Wi-Fi timed out. All right, am I in your party? Yeah.
Have any shout outs you want to do?
Well, this video will be uploaded to both our channels, I think. Yours, Sussy Boy, and mine, Zipper Demon. I'd like to recommend a channel to everyone, and I think you would agree with me. Robot Head has very good videos.
Wow.
They're surprisingly entertaining, even to
Wow.
rewatch them. And for the most part, I agree with them.
Yes, that's what I tried to get you hooked on it. Yeah, he makes quality videos and like.
Yeah, unlike your mic.
Wait, what?
Yeah, unlike your mic.
Oh, okay, sorry. And I was happy to know that we agreed before he released his Rise of Skywalker video. I was hoping that he would say it was worse than Last Jedi, which he did. And I was happy to know that we agree on that.
Yeah. They're both pretty terrible, though.
Yeah, but one goes beyond the Call of Duty. Last Jedi is really only like, it screws up Luke.
I think it's worse than that.
No, I think there was like a too visceral of a reaction. If you look at The Last Jedi, yeah, like Holdo is like a bad character, and Rose does some really stupid stuff, and Finn is totally ignored, and Rey is like way too powerful. But that's like a theme throughout the entire thing. Even Force Awakens, like, was very not Star Warsy. Or it was just like a rehashing of the original trilogy. But then Rise of Skywalker went way beyond and really, really put the series out of its misery. And yeah. And
Yeah, that's.
it was just trying to be like a fan service too. They're like, look, we're rewriting The Last Jedi. It's a good film. It's a good film. Which a lot of people fell for, and it's sad that they fell for that. But like they were just trying to show how many scenes of The Last Jedi they could redo. And none of it worked. Want to say anything, Ethan?
Well, I agree that, well, obviously, Rise of Skywalker is infinitely worse than Last Jedi, but I still do think Last Jedi is terrible.
Yeah. It wasn't what it needed to be. But you know, I feel that a lot of the problems rests on The Force Awakens. Everyone was just like, oh, it's a good setup. Like, nobody thought it was enough. Like, you watch the new Ho A New Hope, and like, it could be a standalone film. It's a good film. But you watch Force Awakens, it needs the second installment for anything to make sense. Because everyone thought that, Kylo would be explained, why does he hate his parents? Everyone was like, oh, Rey's gonna be explained, why she's so powerful. Everyone was like, oh, Snoke, he's gonna be like crazy cool in the second one, and we're gonna figure everything out. Nothing happened. It was a dud. It was like dead on arrival. Because I feel like the second movie had to be amazing, and then the third movie had to be like The Godfather for it to be like considered a good trilogy. But there's like no way. From the start, they got it wrong. The goal was to like make a retro film that was like nostalgic and it was like referencing the originals at all times. They
Yeah.
had their goal wasn't to create something new.
Yeah.
It was to imitate the
It
originals.
was yeah, the same exact template for the movie.
Yeah. And then when they did try to create something new, specifically the last movie, Rise of Skywalker, it was incredible how far they destroyed the universe. Oh yeah. By the way, I thought about this today. It's like, what planet is like iconic from the sequels? Like, you can remember all the planets from the originals, basically, all the names, all the locations, like you have a good idea of what they are. and the prequels, we see like Coruscant and Naboo, and we know those like a lot. And then, of course, we get like the flashes of planets in the third film, and we see Geonosis and stuff like that. But what planet from the originals is like iconic? Jakku's the closest it gets to like an iconic planet.
Yeah.
Or that.
Crate.
Yeah. But they're not even like that interesting, and they're really small scale too. And
Yeah.
that island Luke is on, for some reason they go back to that planet in every single movie.
Yeah.
Why is Luke only on that island? Can he get off the island and do something?
That's the I mean, that's not the worst of the sequels. That's just icing on the cake.
It's just weird. Have you ever heard of like J.J. Abrams, TED Talks?
He does TED Talks.
No, he did a TED Talk like t 10 years ago or something, and he was talking about how his approach to writing is like a mixed mystery box. And everyone made a big deal about it when Force Awakens came out, and they were like referencing the video. And they were like, he's gonna open the box at just the right moment, and it's gonna be something totally different from what everyone expected.
That's cringe.
Yeah, but the thing about him is the box never opens, 'cause he's also famous for like not ending series. Like Star Trek, he didn't really end. Star Wars definitely didn't end well. It was a very weak ending. Rey Skywalker is supposed to be the like cool end, I guess. But I don't know. And Ethan, I have to say, the best looking film is easily The Last Jedi. No, it is. Trust me. Like, look at the planets, look at the ships. Just look at how like everything looks. Look at the costumes, like the throne room scene with Snoke is like the best visual scene of all the sequels. Like the colors are actually like cool. And then like the worst looking film Disney made for Star Wars is Solo.
Oh yeah, that was terrible.
Like it's either gray, it's like gray washed or blue washed. Everything is like one color in that movie. It's hilarious. Like Last Jedi actually looks decent. I liked how the film looked.
Yeah, I mean, well, it almost feels like in a movie that's like special effects heavy, as the special effects get better, the movie gets worse. Right?
Yeah, like the lightning scene in Rise of Skywalker. It's like
Base
more.
boosted
Yeah,
Palpatine.
we just need more things on the screen. We need to pack the screen with as much crap as possible. I want nobody to know what's going on in this scene. Please. Just make it look like a garbage can. And then people will think the movie's good because they'll be so confused by the end. And I predicted like almost everything in that movie, every plot twist in Rise of Skywalker I got. At least Last Jedi, I didn't predict Luke's death. I didn't predict Snoke's death. At least that movie, like, the suspense was way higher. I knew Chewbacca wasn't dead. I said in my head, I was like, I have a feeling he's alive. Because it just fell so flat when they killed him. I was like, why are they killing Chewbacca? He's, first of all, useless in the sequels. They don't even bother using him. So why would they kill him? And then I predicted the end, where Kylo saves Rey. I knew that was going to happen. I told it to you, but you said no way. But yeah, I predicted the two biggest twists.
Yeah.
I
I mean,
knew there was a reason they introduced the force heal at the beginning. I was like, this is going to be like the thing that saves the story from not making any sense whatsoever.
with adding something that doesn't make sense. I
Yeah.
mean, the force heal is really stupid. I mean, there's no other way to put it.
Yeah. Okay, you want to do the recap now?
Sure. So, what did we start off with in this one?
A long time ago, what did we start off with?
We did SpongeBob. I remember that.
Okay, we talked about SpongeBob, Star Wars,
Star Wars we just did.
controversial films, Joker.
How I hate people telling me obvious things. Then we
Yeah.
talked about Mulan and other Disney animated films, and just animated films in general. We talked a little bit about politics,
Oh, yeah.
not much, and then Minecraft, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think that's about it. And now we're doing the recap. So,
Only
yeah.
professionals recap the recap.
Yep, that's true. Well, I think that's good then.
All right.
Yeah.
Signing off the second Suscast.
Yeah.
The date is September 3rd, 2020. And this is the president speaking. Goodbye.
Zipper
And
Demon, Sussy Boy, out.